morning students. Today we are learning the vibration of stress strain. Now here see that the one apparatus is there. This is called as a sonometer. In the sonometer instruments there is a one wire is attached. One thin uniform metal wire is used which is attached at one point and another end is passes over the pulley and at the end of it there we attach the slotted weights. Now after that, if you see that there are the two knife edges are used and in between the knife edges, whatever the length of the wire is there, that is called as a vibrating length. And this vibrating length is denoted by the M. Small m represent the mass per unit length. Mass per unit length means the total mass of the wire is denoted by capital M. And the length of the total length of the wire is L. And that ratio, that is mass per unit length and the L divided by it, that will use as the mass per unit length. Here we can consider the length of this wire is L. Next is that the twinning forks are used. This is a twinning fork which is used to vibrate this string. When we are using the twinning fork, keeping on this table of it, then because of this vibration of the table, the string is start vibrating. When the string is start vibrating, then in between this two knife edges, this we call as a rigid support. This knife edges distance between these two knife edges is a vibrating length L. Because of this two rigid support, the wave which is created, this wave is travel along the string. And when it is rigid support is there, this string is reflected back. Incident wave and reflected wave both will be produce the stationary wave. Now here we can see that the again come to this point L. Small L represent the length of the string between the two rigid support. Total these two rigid supports are there, knife edges are there. Between these two knife edges, that length we call as the vibrating length, that is denoted by small L. Next is at the T. Capital T means whatever the weight we attach at the end of this string, because of this weight, string is stretched. And when string is stretched, whatever the weight is there, that is we are called as the tension on the string. And this tension is measured by the m into g, mass into acceleration due to gravity. We can get the T value of it. Next come to get the small m. Small m represented as a linear density also, and it is also called as a mass per unit length. What is mass per unit length means the mass of this wire and the length of this wire. Taken as a 100 meter wire and the measure the mass of that wire, that ratio gives as the mass per unit length, which is denoted by small m. Now when the wave is created, now see that the, if we consider this diagram, okay, here the wave is produced between the two knife edges, incident wave, after that this wave is reflected, okay, incident wave, and then this wave is reflected, and these two produce as a stationary wave, okay, like that. Here the loop like structure is formed. If we consider this way, the stationary wave is produced. In stationary wave, we know that at the rigid point is there, at this two end node is formed, and at the center of it anti node is formed. Like that we can say that the wave is created, and that wave is a stationary wave having the velocity. This velocity is depends upon the two parameters. This v is equal to under root of t upon small m. The p means the tension on the string and m is the mass per unit length. Already we learned that ratio and the root of it gives us the velocity of this stationary wave, which is produced in between the two knife edges. And this is an important formula for it. V is equal to, already we learned this formula in 11th standard. V is equal to under root of t upon m. Got it? Now here after that we can see that the three diagram we are learning.
First diagram is the first mode of vibration. Second diagram we draw here, and the third diagram again we draw here. That is an A, B, and C. Three diagrams are there. Three different way this waves are created. Three different mode of vibration we call it. First mode of vibration, second mode of vibration, third mode of vibration. First mode of vibration is having the frequency that is called as a fundamental frequency. Next frequency is there, that is a first harmonic is there, or first overtone, and next is that the second harmonic, or the it is a third harmonics, and it is a second overtone. Like that we have to obtain the formula for the different mode of vibration of the frequency. Okay, now student, see, here already we learned this part of it. Okay, V is equal to, remember this formula, V is equal to under root of E upon M. First we are obtaining the formula for the fundamental frequency. Okay, for fundamental frequency we start with the first diagram. Okay, in first diagram, first mode of vibration, in between the two rigid support, in between the two rigid support, the wire is start vibrating, having the length is L. Okay, when the incident wave and it is reflected back, then the and node is formed at the rigid support and anti node is formed at the center of it. Node is formed at the rigid point of it and anti node is formed at the center of this wire. The length of the wire is mentioned by the L. Okay, small l represents the length of the wire. Now our aim is there to find out the frequency. Next is that the already we know that the, here I will draw the diagram of it, how the waves are there. This is the one form of wave, this is the second form of wave. Okay, one form of wave is there, that is a crest and the trough, already we learned here. Next is that the length of this one form of wave is lambda. Got it? And the half of it that we use as a lambda by 2. When the incident wave is reflected, then here it will be produced as the loop like structure. Okay, when it will be reflected, it will be produced the loop like structure, and this is nothing but our stationary wave. Okay, and this loop is having the length is lambda by 2. Total length is lambda, and the one loop, if we consider it, and the one loop is having the distance is lambda by 2, half of this. In this way, if it is only one loop is formed, that distance in terms of the wavelength taken as the lambda by 2. Can we write this wavelength is lambda by 2. Now after that, n is a v is a velocity of it, which is equal to already E upon L. L is a L and lambda with the frequency and the wavelength of this wave. In that case, V is equal to, basic formula is that V is equal to N into lambda. Then N is equal to V upon lambda. Now substitute the value of the V, that is 1 upon lambda into under root of P upon N. That is, n is equal to 1 upon lambda under root of E upon N. Okay. Now next is that the length of the one loop. We consider the basic formula is that length of one loop. Now here is this diagram. We don't need of it. Okay. This is also, our concepts are over. Length of the one loop is equal to, what is that length of one loop? That is lambda by 2, half of the wavelength. Length of one loop is equal to lambda by 2. And here only one loop is formed, and the length of the string is L. Therefore, we write L is equal to lambda by 2. Then lambda is equal to 2L. Cross multiplication, we get lambda is equal to 2L. Now substitute into the equation number 1. after submitting into the equation number 1, it will becomes as n is equal to 1 upon, instead of lambda, we write here 2L. Therefore, 2L and the root of P upon N. This is an important equation which we copy it, here equation number 2. And this is called as, this is fundamental frequency or first harmonics. You see that here, because here n is equal to 1 upon 2L into under root of P upon N. This is a fundamental frequency along the string when we state it, and also it is called as a first harmonic, that is integral multiple of the fundamental frequency, that is called as a harmonic. That's why it is a first harmonics. And in first diagram, that is diagram A, we got this formula for A. Now we come to the